takes. This topic is also practical in nature. So practical questions will come. Along with capital structure analysis, we have to learn the dividend policies also. Now, before starting the practical sum, let us take some important guidelines. Let us discuss about the important guidelines of capital structure. So, we can deeply understand the meaning and concept of the capital structure. The students, capital structure means what? Two words are there, capital and structure. Capital in the form, in the case of accounting or finance, means long-term fund or long-term sources of fund. Say for example, equity shares, preference shares. And structure means pattern. Normally we can use this word for in other general cases also, for example, civil structure or physical structure. So same here, capital structure. So capital structure means a pattern of company's long-term fund. How they have raised the long-term fund through various sources, that is known as capital structure. So very simple, a company's all the sources which are long-term in nature are known as what? Capital structure. So if the company has raised the fund through equity shares, through preference shares, through debentures, through bank loan, that is treated as what? Nothing but what? Capital structure. Now, type. A company may prefer only equity shares. They may not go to the debt fund. The company which is very reputed and having the history of past history of good profitability, they can go for only equity shares to raise the fund from the market. So equity shares, so that means in such case the capital structure is made of only equity shares. Or company may go for preference shares, say for example 80% they have raised the fund through equity shares and 20% through preference shares. Or they may use debt funders. Now, the capital structure may be only equity, only debt, or combination of equity and debt. The company who uses the debt capital or loan capital in their capital structure is called as levered fund. Levered fund means the company who have infused debt fund in their capital structure is called as nothing but for levered fund. Now, why company go for debt fund? Because the debt fund is cheaper than the equity fund. Also, it gives a tax benefit. So that is the main part of the preference of the debt capital. But company should not borrow lot of money through debt capital, otherwise it will increase the financial risk to its equity shareholder and it may lead to the bankruptcy. So there should be a proper trade-off between the equity capital and debt capital. Now, why the capital structure is important? See, if the new idea, or say for example, the company's new project which company is going to execute may fetch good profitability, but cost of capital is also important. They should keep in mind the cost of capital of the fund. For example, the fund which you have invested gives you 20% return. But if your cost of capital is more than 20%, then there is no use. So there should be a proper trade-off between the cost of capital and the fund which you have invested through such long-term sources should give you some more. That means you should get some margin with the from that long-term capital. So cost of capital, for example, at 10%, at least you should get the return 12% or 15%. In such case only company can increase or maximize the wealth of their shareholder. So if they have selected the wrong sources for financing their project, definitely that project will go in vain, that project will be non-profitable, loss-making, and company may have to wipe up or they have to wind the existing capital decision and company may have to face a lot of loss in long term, for the long term period. Which factors they have to keep in mind while designing the optimal capital structure? Now, what is the meaning of optimal capital structure? Optimal capital structure means the capital structure which increases or maximizes the earning per share of the company shareholder, as well as the capital structure which maximizes the wealth of the company shareholder. So first of all, they have to keep in mind the cost of capital. Say for example, we have already done the cost of capital. So equity shares cost of capital is 20%. Yes. So equity capital cost is 20% and debt capital is 12%, and their portion in the total capital structure is 50-50. Ultimately, the cost of capital will be 16%. So cost of capital should be less than the internal rate of return which they are going to get with the implementation of that capital structure. Further, they have to keep in mind the gearing. How much debt is to be used? The debt should not be more, should not be less. Means the company should not be overcapitalized and undercapitalized. So there should be a proper trade-off between the debt and equity capital. So some theories are there, some theories are developed in past century, and with the help of these theories, some finance managers are taking decisions. So first of all, we will discuss the net operating income approach. Net operating income approach. This is one theory which is very traditional in nature. It suggests that if company wants to raise fund through the long term sources, they should give maximum preference to the debt. Jitna debt capital diya jayega, utna company ke liye acha hai, because the debt capital is cheaper. So iska jo benefit hai, ultimately kisko milega? Equity shareholder. So this theory suggests that maximum debt capital is to be infused in capital structure. On the other hand, there is another theory which is called as net income approach. It suggests that debt capital or equity capital, doesn't matter, it is not going to increase the company's earning per share. How? ये बोलता है कि अगर आप debt capital बढ़ा रहे हो, if you are increasing the debt capital, definitely it will reduce the overall capital structure cost, but it will increase the equity's expectation, because as soon as you increase the debt capital, financial risk increases, and if risk increases, return should increase. तो जितना आपको benefit debt capital increase करके मिलता है, बराबर उतना ही setup हो जाएगा equity cost increase से, and कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. For example, अगर आपने सोचा है, if you thought that equity and debt capital, equity you are going to use 70% and 30% debt. In this case, what will happen? The equity capital may be cost of capital 18% and debt 12%. But if you are going to increase the debt capital with 50-50, then this may be 12%, but equity shareholder expectation will increase. It may go to the 22%. So it will compensate whatever benefit you are going to receive with the infusion of maximum debt capital, that will be saved up with the increased cost of equity. So it suggests that whatever capital structure you are going to take, you are going to raise a fund through the capital structure that is not going to benefit you. The cost of capital in every capital structure design is same. What is important, you have to increase the operating income. The third is a traditional approach. Under the traditional approach, it suggests that first the company should give preference to the debt capital, but at a certain limit. Thereafter, it should not raise the fund through the debt capital. Say for example, 60% they should raise the fund through the debt capital and 40% equity. Even though they are getting 80% loan from the bank, they should not go for it. So if they were to debt, they need to. And another is a modification. भी कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर ऑप्टिमम नहीं होगा. सो द कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर व्हिच इंक्रीजेस द नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट शुड बी एक्सेप्टेड. सो एक कंप्लीटली अलग इंक्रीज इट टोटली फोकस ऑन फ्यूचर प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ फ्यूचर कैश इनफ्लोस. सो एमएम अप्रोच इज देयर. फर्दर देयर इज अनदर थ्योरी व्हिच इज कॉल्ड पेगिंग ऑर्डर थ्योरी. Making order suggests that company should give first preference to the accumulated profit, that is the reserve. Thereafter, they should go to the existing equity shareholder. Then they should raise the fund to the debt finances. So, making order always prefers the accumulated profit and thereafter the right issue shares. And another one is the bankruptcy theory. Bankruptcy theory suggests that whenever the company wishes to raise fund through the debt capital, the equity capital normally considers the bankruptcy cost. Bankruptcy means if the company has taken a lot of loan and tomorrow if company is not going to solve or not going to discharge the liability of the debt capital, they will seize the assets of the company. And as you know that the seized assets may not get the full value in the market and they will lose the maximum value of the fixed assets. So that is going to impact on the equity's return because they are the residual earnings. So the bankruptcy phase is there. So this is the theoretical part. It may be asked in your last question, which is optional to your objective. Now what is the practical part? So maximum one question will be there in your examination regarding the calculation of earning per share and market price per share. So I'm going to present the format on the board and I will explain and thereafter we will solve the problem. Students, this is the format for calculation of earning per share. Now, how to calculate the earning per share? Very easy. Already we have done in ratio analysis. But this is the format. First, we will get the information about the earning before interest and tax. This information you will get from the question. This interest. If in the capital structure company is using debt capital, then you have to get the interest there. Whatever the percentage are, they will give in the question. And the interest you have to get. Then thereafter you will get the earning before tax. Less tax you will get earning after tax. Less preference dividend you will get profit available to equity shareholder. So profit available to equity shareholder divided by number of equity share is nothing but what earning per share. See, earning before interest and tax means return available to the investors. They may be a debt financer, may be equity financer, may be preference shareholder. So first commitment is towards the interest. Thereafter, government, whatever tax deduction will be there, and we will get the earning after tax. From earning after tax, first amount is to be given to the preference shareholder because they are having After that, after generating the preference dividend share, you will gain the profit of the equity share. As you know that the equity shareholders are always known as residual earners. Whatever is there, that belongs to the equity shareholder. So divided by the number of equity shares, you will get the return. And the market price per share is very easy. Earning per share into price earning ratio, you will get the market price per share. So that will be given in the question. Now, capital structure may be made of equity shares, preference shares, reserve and surplus, or debenture. Depends on the situation. So, question will give you the guidelines. What type of capital structure is there? They may give you 2-3 options, and then you have to select the best option. So, lot of things are there, lot of factors are there that we will discuss one by one. But maximum decision is taken on the basis that the said capital structure should increase the weight of the equity share without compromising or without compromising the interest of the other stakeholder. Company need to increase the equity shareholder weight. So, before going in detail, let us discuss the practical question here on what type of question comes in the examination. So, what we will do? We will go for question number 15, page number 242. Question number 15, page number 242. One of the limited has equity share capital of Rs. 5 lakh divided into shares of Rs. 100 each. It wishes to raise further 3 lakh for expansion of moderation scheme. The company has to follow financing alternatives. They are having some 4 alternates. One by issue of equity shares, one by issue of 1 lakh equity shares and 2 lakh through 10% debentures. Third is 10% loan and fourth is 1 lakh equity shares and 2 lakh 8% preference shares. You are required to suggest the best alternative giving your comments, assuming that the estimated earning before interest and tax after expansion is 1,50,000 and corporate rate tax is 35%. So students, first of all, we will prepare what is our first work, first job. We have to write down the working note. सबसे पहले हम लोग को working note करना है. इस question में क्या हुआ है देखो. ये जो company है, उसको 5 लाख रुपए already इनके पास है और 3 लाख रुपए और चाहिए. 5 लाख ऑलरेडी इनके पास है और 3 लाख रुपए चाहिए और ये 3 लाख रुपए वसूल करने के लिए इनके पास चार ऑप्शन से इनको एक फंड लाने का जिसमें अलग-अलग स्कीम दिया है. तो चारों को हम लोगों को सामने रख के सबसे उसमें से जो बेस्ट है वो सिलेक्ट करने का और वो करने के लिए हमारे पास कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन दी है. तो मैं पहले 4 वर्किंग नोट बनाऊंगा कि अगर ऑप्शन 1 सिलेक्ट किया गया तो क्या कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर रहेगा, ऑप्शन 2 सिलेक्ट किया गया तो क्या कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर रहेगा, ऑप्शन 3 ऑप्शन 4 में, और फिर हम लोग उसको यहां टेस्ट करेंगे. तो स्टूडेंट्स, पहले हम लोग वर्किंग नोट बनाएंगे. यस, ऑप्शन 1 सबके पास ऑलरेडी इक्विटी शेयर्स है कंपनी के पास. कितने हैं? 5 लाख एंड 5000 इक्विटी शेयर्स है और कंपनी को और 3 लाख रुपए इक्विटी शेयर्स से चाहिए. तो मैं यहां लिखूंगा पहला ऑप्शन इक्विटी शेयर्स ऑफ रुपीस 100 इच. पहले से इनके पास 5 लाख है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स और 3 लाख चाहिए. कितना हो गया? 5 + 3 = 8 लाख. तो 8 लाख इज द गोल. एक शेयर अगर 100 रुपए का है एनी ऑलरेडी एनी टोटल नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स कितने हो गए? 80,000. कैसे? पहले 50,000 थे पर अभी 30,000. वेरी सिंपल, 5 लाख प्लस 3 लाख 8 लाख. 8 लाख रुपए के शेयर्स है, एक शेयर 100 रुपए का, यानी नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स नथिंग बट 80,000. ऑप्शन 2 जो है, देखो स्टूडेंट्स, ऑलरेडी तो 5 लाख है और 3 लाख चाहिए, सब में टोटल 8 लाख ही रहेगा, लेकिन ये सोर्स चेंज हो सकता है. तो 1 लाख थ्रू इक्विटी शेयर्स एंड 2 लाख थ्रू डिबेंचर्स. कौन से डिबेंचर्स? 10%. तो मैं यहां लिखूंगा 1 लाख. अभी देखो यहां 3 लाख थे तो 30,000 हुए, 1 लाख थे तो 10,000 हुआ, यानी नए शेयर्स 10,000 प्लस जूने वाले 50,000, टोटल 60,000 इक्विटी शेयर्स. of rupees 100 each. Yes? और उसके बाद 2 लाख रुपए थ्रू 10% डिवेंचर्स.
Because in first situation also 25 लाख already है plus
10 lakhs total 35 lakhs. So 25 lakh rupees 100 rupees share, which means number of shares existing 25,000 and further 1,000. Sorry, 10,000 means total ho gaya 25,000 plus 10,000, 35,000 equity shares. Kaise hai 35,000 equity shares? 35 lakh divided by 100. 35 lakh divided by 100. This is option 1. Option 2. Option 2 kaise hai? Already equity shares nahi, hamare 25 lakh. Usme aur 5 lakh equity shares add hoge. Because option 2 bolte 5 lakh equity shares, 5 lakh to give it. So 25 lakhs plus 5 lakhs, 90 lakhs. So number of equity shares 30,000. Kyunki ek share 100 rupaye ka hai, simple. Jitna amount in the lakhs ko 100 se divide, you will get the number of shares. Why number of shares important? To divide with divide to the earning available to the equity share. Otherwise, you don't earning per share nahi. And the debenture plan. Debenture kitna hai? To 10% debenture is 5. Option 3. Option 3 kya hai? The problem with here 5 lakh through equity shares, 3 lakh through preference shares and 2 lakh through debentures. So क्या होगा? Same case. Already 25,000 है और 5,000 आएंगे तो company के पास 30,000 equity shares होंगे. Yes. और 3 lakhs through preference shares and 10% debentures से 2 lakhs. So 8% preference shares. And 10% debentures 2 lakhs. And option 4. Option 4 last. 25 lakhs already equity shares hai. No equity shares. 5 lakhs through debentures, 5 lakhs through preferences. And in jo already equity shares hai, wahi rahenge. 25 lakhs, and thereafter 10% debentures and 8% preferences. 8% preferences 5 lakh, and 10% debentures 5 lakhs. These are the four options company is having. Company can go either fully through equity shares, 10 lakh rupees, they can raise only through equity shares, or they can raise 5 lakhs through equity shares, 5 lakhs through debentures, or 5 lakhs through equity shares, 3 lakhs through preference shares, and 2 lakhs through debentures, or last option, 5 lakhs preference shares, 5 lakhs debentures, through equity shares. So these are the four possibilities. In front of company, there are four possibilities. Company has to select the best one. Now, let us discuss these four possibilities with our format. If company invested 35 lakhs in the project, their EBIT will be 5. कोई भी केस ले लो, 5 लाख रुपए EBIT ले. Yes. What about the interest? पहले केस में तो डिबेंचर कोई लोन ही नहीं है. No interest will be paid. So before tax 5 lakhs. Yes, but in second option, yes, there is a 5 lakhs of this debentures to be paid. So 5 lakhs will be 10% and 5% will be 4 lakhs. Third way, yes, if not I can be suggest because 2 lakhs are debentures. So 4 lakhs 80,000. And last way, yes, 5 lakhs hai, 50,000. As you know that 30% tax rate is there in the new case, in this problem 30% tax commitment is there. So here it will come 1,50,000 and the shareholder will get 7,50,000. 4,50,000 ka 30% 4,50,000 ka 30% is 1,35,000. entire profit which is available after a tax is available to the equity share. In option 2, what will happen? Yes, though there is a debenture, but no preference commitment is there, no preference dividend, 3,15,000. In third case, yes, preference shares are there, how much to be valued? It's 3,8%. 24,000 is a preference commitment. So 3,36,000 minus 24,000, 3,12,000. And last one, here, final preference shares are there at the rate 8%. So 40,000 is commitment. So the equity shareholder will be 2,75,000. Now, equity shareholder will get 750,000 in first case, and the number of shares are 35,000 already computed. So 750 divided by 35,000. So the earning per share will be 10. Sorry, the earning per share will be 750,000 divided by 35,000. 750,000 divided by 35,000. This will give the new earning per share. You can calculate. It will go around exactly. I will have to use the calculator. So you can calculate with this 750,000 divided by 35,000. Here, sorry, not 750, sorry, it's 3,50,000. Sorry, 3,50,000. So it will come 10 rupees, rupees 10. Here, 3,15,000, and the number of shares are 30,000. 3,15,000 divided by 30,000, so it will become 8.5. यहाँ 3,12,000 है और number of shares है 30,000. आपको मिल जाएगा 3,12,000 divided by 30,000, 8.4. और यहाँ 2,75,000 divided by 25,000, तो आपको answer मिल जाएगा 11. आप देखो कौन सा बेस्ट है, सबसे बेस्ट है ए, जिसमें आपको मिल जाएगा 11 रुपीस. सो ऑप्शन 4 इज बेस्ट, ऑप्शन 4 इज बेस्ट. ठीक है, अब एक क्वेश्चन मैं डिस्कस करूंगा. इधर वी विल डिस्कस वन क्वेश्चन, दैट इज होमवर्क फॉर यू. मैक्सिमम क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू सॉल्व. एनी डाउट्स आर देयर देन यू हैव टू आस्क मी. वी विल गो टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 16 स्टूडेंट्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 16, आई विल रीड द क्वेश्चन which you have to manage. The existing capital structure of ABC Limited is as follows. Equity shares 40 lakhs, retail earnings 10 lakhs, 9% preference shares 25 lakhs, and 7% debentures 25. This is their existing capital structure. Company earns return before interest and tax at the rate 12%, and the tax on income is 50%. And company want to raise 25 lakhs for its expansion program, for which it considering the following alternates. There are having 3 alternates. He said that equity shares issued for 25 rupees premium. As you know that premium, security premium is a profit which company gets at the issue of equity shares or preference shares. Yeah, if the stock of preference shares issued for, they are 9% debentures issued. Or in this case, in this case, the price earning ratio is given.
Retail earnings 10 lakhs,
9% preferential. How much? 25. And 7% debentures. 25. Total 1 crore. A company need 25. Therefore, if they go for option 1, current capital structure was the carrying impact. Carrying impact. पहले बताए 20,000 इक्विटी शेयर्स इशू स्टूडेंट्स क्या हुआ है देखो अगर ऑप्शन वन सिलेक्ट किया जाए 40,000 की जगह पे 20,000 और शेयर्स ऐड हो जाएंगे इससे कितना हो जाएगा 60,000 बराबर है एक शेयर 100 रुपए 40,000 की जगह पे कितना हो जाएगा 60 बट इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर 20,00,000 नहीं देंगे 20,00,000 देंगे प्लस 25 रुपए एक्स्ट्रा सो विद 20,000 इक्विटी नंबर ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स विल गेट 25 रुपीज ईच per share extra that is nothing but what your profit so 25 into 20,000 how much 5x that is your security and if you have a reserve and surplus may add 15 lakh rupees kaisa hai students dekho ek share jo tha wo tha 100 rupees ka issue karte samay ye 125 yani 100 rupees is face value and 25 rupees is nothing but what सिक्योरिटी प्रीमियम फेस वैल्यू है कैपिटल में है जो सिक्योरिटी प्रीमियम का मनी है वो रिटेन अर्निंग्स में है तो ये हो गया इधर 15 तो ऐसे केस में आपका ये बन जाएगा 1 करोड़ दिस इज ऑप्शन अगर हम लोग ऑप्शन 2 में जाते हैं तो इक्विटी शेयर्स के ऊपर तो कुछ नहीं होगा नो इक्विटी शेयर्स सो इट विल बी ओनली 40x No equity share, therefore no new security premium, therefore retained earnings will remain same. हाँ, but second case में क्या हो रहा है? 10% preference shares issued किए गए, already 9% preference shares है, और पूरे 25 लाख के और 10% preference shares ओल्ड वाला 9% एंड न्यू वाला 10% 25x एंड द लास्ट वन इज 7% डिबेंचर्स दैट विल रिमेन सेम तो ऑप्शन 2 में क्या हो गया स्टूडेंट्स ऑप्शन 2 में क्या हो गया कि इक्विटी शेयर्स उतने ही रहे रिटेल अर्निंग्स उतने ही रहे 9% प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स के साथ साथ 10% प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स और 7% डिबेंचर्स ओके दो ऑप्शंस हैं पहले हम लोग इन दो ऑप्शंस का देखते हैं पर ऑप्शंस इधर जगह नहीं है सो दैट वी विल राइट डाउन वेरी सी यू आर अर्निंग दिस कंपनी अर्निंग आफ्टर इन्वेस्टमेंट विल बिकम हाउ मच बिकॉज़ दे आर गेटिंग 12% रिटर्न जितना भी इन्वेस्टमेंट किया जाता है उसका 12% एक उनको रिटर्न मिलता है यहां अमाउंट नहीं प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस के वाले 50,500 दिया था here they have put 12%. So return on capital employed is always 12% in this company. So 1 crore 25 lakhs ka 12% comes how much? Around 6, it comes 15 lakh rupees. 1 crore 25 lakhs ka 12% comes 15 lakhs. So earning before interest and tax is 15 lakhs. ऑप्शन वन इंटरेस्ट हियर इंटरेस्ट कमिटमेंट इज ऑन 25 रुपीस के ऊपर 7% 25x का 7% इज हाउ मच स्टूडेंट्स 25x का 7% तो द इंटरेस्ट कॉस्ट इज 1,75,000 इफ यू डिडक्ट यू विल गेट 13,25,000 ऑप्शन टू में इंटरेस्ट कितना है सेम 7% सो हियर आल्सो इट विल कम 1,75,000 ऑप्शन 3 के ऊपर मैं जाऊंगा अभी मेरे पास जगह नहीं है क्योंकि ऑप्शन 3 का बात करता हूं दोस्तों सो सेम केस 13.25 टैक्स माइनस टैक्स रेट गिवन इन द प्रॉब्लम इज 50% हाफ सो इन ऑप्शन 1 After tax profit is 6,961. Same case. Now, what about the preference dividend? Preference shares are there, 25x and 9%. So 1,75%. Yes, 9%. So 25x and 9%, which comes only 2,25,000. Here are some. In this case, there are two preferences. पहले वाले के ऊपर आएगा 2,25,000 और नए के ऊपर आएगा 2,50,000. Total preference dividend commitment in option 2 is old coupon 25x का 9% means 2,25,000 और जो नया preference है उसके ऊपर 25x का 10% means 2,50,000. तो total commitment will be 2,25,000 plus 2,50,000 and 4,75,000. So 6,62,500 minus 2,25,000 we get 2,87,500. Here the answer will be changed. The answer will be different in alternate second. So here the return will be
case 4.69
129.99. So according to the market price, option number 1 is good, and according to the earning per share, option 3 is good. Okay? Thank you very much. Now, we will discuss one more question. Question number 21, page number 247. A company needs 31,25,000 for the construction of new plant. The following three plans are feasible. Plan number 1, company may issue 3,12,500 equity shares of rupees 10 per share. Second, the company may issue 1,56,250 ordinary equity shares at rupees 10 per share and balance through 8% debentures. Third, company may issue 156,250 equity shares at rupees 10 per share and balance with 100 rupees 15,625 preference shares at the rate 8% dividend. If the company's earning before interest and taxes are 60,500, 1,25,000, 2,50,000, 3,75,000, and 6,25,000, what are the earnings per share under each of three financial plans? Assume corporate income tax rate 40%. Second, which alternate would you prefer? And third, determine the financial break-even point or PBIT EPS between plan 1 and 2 and plan 1 and 3. Now, third is little bit different. I will explain in detail. But first of all, we have to prepare the working. Now, if company goes for first option, what their capital structure look like? 3,12,500 equity shares of rupees 10 each, 31,25,000. This is option. Then option 2. What will happen? Yes. 1,56,250 equity shares of rupees 10 each. And balance debentures, 8% debentures. Option 3. Yes. 1,56,250 equity shares. Yes, these are the three options available in front of the company. Now, yes, students, first of all, they have given 62,000. See, now these work we have to do for 5 times. We have to do 5 times because EBIT is given 5 times. Very easy. You can take first 62,500. You can take 125, you can take 250, you can take 375, and you can take 625. So I will take two values, baki ki inhein wo aapko. So first of all, 62,500 is okay nahi hoga, 1,25,000 diya. 62,500 dal ke aap log calculation kar. Agar company sochti hai ki investment karke humko 1,25,000 milega, to kya situation? Very simple. 1,25,000 interest minus pehle ki tax rate is given. So tax rate is 40%. 1,25,000 का 40%. स्टूडेंट्स कितना आता है? 50,000. 1,25,000. इधर तो सवाल ही नहीं है, कॉपी नहीं है. सेम चीज है. 1,25,000 - 50,000.
Always preferable in all.
maximum focus should be offshore too. When company's income is more than,
yes,
1,25,000. If company's earning is more than 1,25,000, they should go for option. If their earning is less than 1,25,000, they should go for option. Now the last point again is calculate the EPAT EPS in difference point between option 1 and 2 and option 2 and 3. There are three possibilities. You can calculate between option 1 and 2, option 2 and 3, and option 1 and 3. So what I will do, I will compute between the 2 and thereafter the balance part we have to manage. Now what is the meaning of in difference there? Very easy. It's not easy.
Maybe not.
माइनस ए वन है ए, यहाँ पर एक लिख लो, मैंने ये इक्वेशन सॉल्व करके उसको टू से मल्टीप्लाई करना है, 0.60 इनटू 1 है 25, तो ये आ रहा है तकरीबन यस 75. Yes. So what will be the answer? 0.6x is equal to this multiple to 1.2x minus 1,50,000. Now solve the equation. So we have here 1.2x minus equal to minus 0.6x is equal to 1,50,000. So x is equal to 1,50,000 divided by 0.6. So 1,50,000 of 0.6 divided by 0.6. You will get an answer. Yes, 2,50,000. So, if the company has 2,50,000, option 1 or option 2 option 2 option और ऑप्शन 1 और ऑप्शन 3 में डिस्कस। सो मैं अभी आपको ऑप्शन 2 और ऑप्शन 3 करके दे दूंगा, ऑप्शन 1 और ऑप्शन 3 आपको, तो ये पॉइंट हो गया। वैसे ही केस तो यहां मैं करूंगा, इंस्टेड ऑफ 1 आई विल राइट ऑफ हियर 2 एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ 2 आई विल राइट ऑफ हियर 3, दैट मींस ऑफ बिटवीन प्लान 2 एंड प्लान 3 व्हाट विल हैपन, सेम कैलकुलेशन
this topic or previous topic.